Check out the simple yet practical approaches you can employ if you wish to choose good mutual funds. While investing in mutual funds, the primary factor to consider is how the fund generates returns. A good mutual fund generates returns consistently, not sporadically. You should select funds that align with your financial objectives and your risk appetite. You should also look at the fund's performance across market cycles, that is, when the market is highly volatile, bullish, and bearish. Now, let's look at the quantitative factors. You should check out the fund's trailing returns, which is essentially a measure of the mutual fund's performance for the past specific periods. For instance, how the fund performed in the past 1 year, 3 years, 5 years, or from the time of inception to present day. Basically, trailing return is a calculation of point-to-point returns and analyzing them. Another way to pick a good mutual fund is to check out its rolling returns, which typically average out a series of returns over and above the overlapping periods. It also measures your mutual fund returns at various points of time, thus eliminating any bias associated with returns observed over a specific point of time. While the trailing returns show a fund's performance in the long run, yet, from the available data, it can be difficult to understand a fund's returns generating consistency and performance in good and bad market cycles. On the other hand, rolling returns calculates the overall yield of the fund over some time at specific intervals, thus enabling you to choose the best fund in terms of consistency and performance. You can find a few websites that show rolling returns as well. While choosing good mutual funds to invest in, you should also check for standard deviation, which basically tells you how much the returns from your fund portfolio are deviating from the average returns based on the fund's historical performance. Standard deviation is directly proportional to portfolio volatility and is also used in calculating Sharpe's ratio, which we shall talk about later in this video. Another factor to consider while choosing a good mutual fund is its beta coefficient according to your risk appetite. The beta coefficient measures a mutual fund's volatility or systematic risk in comparison to the market as a whole. It represents how an investment's returns will respond to market movements. For mutual funds, the market typically refers to the benchmark index followed by the fund, for example, Nifty. The benchmark index is always taken as 1.0. Any beta less than 1 indicates that the fund returns are less volatile than market returns of the benchmark index. In case the beta is higher than 1, it denotes that the fund returns are more volatile than market returns of the index. As an investor, you should choose funds' beta ratio according to your risk-taking capacity. If you are a conservative investor, you should focus on investing in funds with low beta to avoid value erosion. However, if you have a high risk appetite, you may focus on funds with high beta for higher returns. You can measure your mutual fund's risk-adjusted returns with Sharpe ratio. The Sharpe ratio is calculated by considering the average fund returns minus the risk-free rate of returns and then divided by the standard deviation of fund returns. The Sharpe ratio shows the excess return you will earn relative to the standard deviation or volatility of the fund. If a fund's Sharpe ratio is higher in relation to its peers, it indicates the fund's ability to produce better returns. By combining all the above strategies, you can find good mutual funds generating excellent returns.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.